need to start by gaining access to the air filter assembly. This is going to be different depending on your make and model. This encased unit, you can just pop the side cover off. Remove the air box so that you can gain access to the carburetor. If your airbox has these inserts, you want to pop those out. Some airboxes will need to be drilled out though, to allow for the barrel nuts to slide through. Slide the hose onto the hose barb of the Venturi adapter, and take a look at the writing on the Venturi. It will say carb side. That will always face the carburetor, and this will go onto the face of the carburetor, leave the gasket that's on there. Depending on your make and model, the Venturis will be different, and they will match the design of the carburetor. You'll just want to try to slide it on there and get it to set, so that way you can have access to it to get the airbox back on. The idea behind the barrel nuts is that they will reach through the airbox and anchor onto the studs. That way you don't have to back your studs out. Sometimes a couple washers are required in this area to make sure everything snugs up well. Sometimes at the bottom of the filter, you'll have a gap. You can save the bushings you removed from the top of the airbox and use those to fill the gap and use the original bolt at the bottom. On most units, you're able to reinstall everything without having to modify anything. Some units can be tighter and closed, or the frame is too close to the generator itself. You'll actually have to cut or modify the generator to allow the Venturi adapter to fit. On this particular unit, no modification is required. If you have a side cover, you can go ahead and put that back on. On some units, modifying the side cover for the supply hose is required. On this particular unit, we're just going to use the oil access door. You can go ahead and install this fitting and this fitting. Sometimes, depending on the kit design, this will be a hose barb or a pipe thread to flare. This is your load block, and this will go in here. Since these are pipe thread fittings, they will require tape, dope, or both. Depending on the kit you purchased, you'll have different parts that come in the kit. This particular bracket is very common. It's found on most can kits. It will fit any can regulator. Screws in right on the bottom there. A very generic mounting bracket. You can also use these two tabs to mount the regulator wherever convenient. And on this particular kit, you can see here we're using a bar clamp type mount. You also have different load blocks that come in the kit. Some of them are smaller or larger depending on the size. This is a very common one. It fits quite a few different generators and flows quite a bit. You also have some brass ones and some quick connection type load blocks. These ports are going to be on the bottom of every can regulator, and they need to be open at all times. Sometimes you'll have plugs in there. When they come, they need to be removed. This is an atmospheric vent. As far as mounting the regulator, any position, you can rotate this in any position except for flat. You cannot mount these flat or they will not operate correctly. At this point, if you're running natural gas or low pressure propane, you can go ahead and run your supply into the inlet of the can regulator. Maximum inlet into this regulator is 13.8 inches water column, which translates to about half a PSI. Anything more than that and you'll have to have it regulated down. Most units work with a 9 to 13 inch water column range, or 6 to 8 ounces. A lot of natural gas is lower pressure though, in the 4, 5, 6, 7 inch water column range. If that's the case, just let us know. We can build them to work with that pressure. But if you were setting up for natural gas or low pressure propane, you can go ahead and move on to the next step of supplying your line into the inlet here. The tri-fuel conversion kit will come with a set of these, one for each end of the hose. Sometimes they're one-piece unit where it's pipe thread, two barb. This particular unit is with a flare adapter. The flare end does not require any tape or dope. The pipe thread end does. On this particular hose, a tiny bit of lubrication is fine, and all you have to do is slide the hose onto the hose barb and it locks in place. These are push-lock fittings and do not require hose clamps. You can take the green or silver single-stage regulator, or sometimes a twin-stage regulator that's included in the tri-fuel kit. Assemble the POL connection and the flare connection. These are both pipe thread going into the regulator, and they both do require tape or dope. The flare connection will connect here, and then this fitting is a left-hand POL fitting. So instead of turning clockwise, it will turn counterclockwise, and that's how it will attach to the tank.